What's up, Collider fans? Josh Macuga here with Grace Hancock, formerly of the show Collider TV Talk. Now, you've seen our best news shows of 2017, but these are our best shows of 2017. Now, Grace, you took some of your best news shows and threw them in the best.
Right. I did want to specify that there were a lot of really great news shows. This was a great year for television. Some of my shows that are on my best list are new shows, but I left them off that list because they're so damn good.
And I have a bit of crossover. So again, these are personal lists, best of 2017. Let's get it started. Grace, what's in your five spot?
All right. So in my number five spot, I did Big Little Lies on HBO. This was a phenomenal ensemble female cast. Reese Witherspoon, Nicole Kidman, Laura Dern. It was so, 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 so good. It was so moving. I thought I was going to hate the show, and I loved it, and I cried.
And they're getting a season two.
Yeah.
A little bit of an open end there. Here we go, going back to Monterey. All right, in my fifth spot is The Leftovers, probably the most underrated show in the history of television. Damon Lindelof, you know, he created another creepy world. Carrie Coon, it was an absolute vision. This launched her career. This woman had no credits, basically, to her name up until the show, and her and Justin Theroux absolutely knocked this out of the park. It is one of the creepiest, most well-done shows. It really makes you think. The Leftovers in my five spot. What you got in four,
nice.
Grace?
Number four, I have, of course, The Punisher, John Bernthal. In the same way that I feel like Julia Louis-Dreyfus was meant to play Veep, mm-hmm. I feel like this is like the role that like the gods and the planets aligned, and they were like, you will be Frank Castle. And we were all like, yay! And I love it. Yeah, this is like everything I want out of a TV show. It's super dark, it's super gritty, it's kind of like a la Fincher, totally my jam. I love every minute. Kill all the people.
Dark, no waffling, he kills.
Yeah,
kill.
With his like raspy voice and like his hoodie, I was in.
Guess what's in my fourth spot?
What?
The Punisher!
No!
We agreed, the first time ever, it all came together like a confluence of three rivers in a beautiful city in western Pennsylvania. Okay.
Wow.
The Punisher, to me, I said it before in our best of 2017, The Punisher is the best show Marvel has ever done. Daredevil season one, very, very close. Like, you could put them right here, but for me, there is nothing better than The Punisher. John Bernthal, again, knocks it out of the park. All right, what's in your three spot?
In my number three spot, I did not think I was gonna like the show, and it is so good, I cannot praise it highly enough, is The Marvelous Mrs. Maisel on Amazon. It is insane. Okay, but I told you this, the logo for that show looks a lot like Bewitched.
Yes.
And it looked like just kind of feminine and like flu-flu, and I was like, I'm gonna hate this show. So I didn't watch it for months because of the logo. So they need to redo their branding because I feel like the show is so much better than the logo, as it should be. But I was blown away. This is like the best production value, the most amazing production design. Rachel Brosnahan, am I saying that right?
Yep.
Is absolute gold. I hope she wins all the awards.
Me too.
I loved every minute of it. It's so snappy. I loved it.
Nailed it. And from playing a prostitute down on her luck to this amazing woman in Marvelous Mrs. Maisel. The prostitute in House of Cards to Marvelous Mrs. Maisel. It's unbelievable. All right, my three is Halt and Catch Fire. No, again, nobody's watching this show. It's on AMC. It's about the birth of computers, the internet, all that kind of stuff. Four seasons. It's over. It's series finale. Had me in tears, almost like I just couldn't do anything the rest of the day. It's an amazing show. Everybody should be watching it. It's my number three, best of 2017. Grace, what's your two?
Oh my God, number two is Mr. Mercedes on the Audience Network. I cannot speak highly enough about this show. It is so dark, it's so gritty. Freaking, he is so good. I can't, like, Brendan, all the things, all the awards. It was just heart-stoppingly gory and intense and dark, and the guy plays such a good villain. I just thought it was so crisp start to finish. I loved every single episode.
Mr. Mercedes. All right, my number two is Marvelous Mrs. Maisel. Marvelous Mrs. Maisel, we've talked about it ad nauseum. I don't think I need to say anymore. If you're not watching it, watch it. If you are watching it and you loved it, you know what we're talking about. If you're somewhere in between and you're somewhere where they don't have a TV, get Amazon, get a TV, and watch The Marvelous Mrs. Maisel. I can't praise it highly enough. All right, Grace, I think we both have obviously.
I mean, I'm
one.
Sure you, me, the internet, the world at large, the aliens across the street, obviously number one has got to be Game of Thrones. There has There's never been event television like this. I don't know that there's ever going to be event television that quite matches this.
Yes.
The show has something for everybody, and I mean that literally every single person on the planet, and it's phenomenal. I love it.
It's not getting any worse. It's only getting better. Dragons with blue fire. Everything is coming at you. Who knows when the next season's going to come out? It'll probably be out when my beard is down to here. Don't worry, I'm ashamed. I'm kidding.
Me too.
That's our best of 2017. Game of Thrones hits our number one, obviously, but there's a ton of other shows out there you guys should be watching.
So much.
Tune in for our worst of 2017, and also if you haven't checked out our best new shows of 2017, check those out. I'm Josh Macuga, at Josh Macuga on Twitter and Instagram.
I'm Grace Hancock, at Mrs. Grace Face online everywhere.
See you next time. That was our top five. Now we have one little special treat for you guys. It's called Left Off.
Left Off.
One show that everybody seemed to love that I'm gonna leave off. That's Stranger Things 2. Left Off.
No, Left Off, this is us. Go screw yourself, you freaking soap opera.
Left Off.
Left Off.